Hi everyone, and welcome to the .NET MAUI DataForm tutorial. The DataForm control is used to create or edit data forms such as sign-in, sign-up, registration, payment forms and more based on the business purpose. In this video, I will demonstrate how to add an image, create and add a custom editor, and show you how to commit values to the custom editor. I am using an existing MAUI application where I've configured the necessary DataForm namespace and added the MAUI DataForm control. In this working example, I've also bound the model class to collect the first name, last name, and more to collect the contact details. If you want to learn how to add data form to an app, I recommend watching the Getting Started video linked to the card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. I'll run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the data form is displayed to collect contact information. Here, you can see only the editors are displayed. Now, I will demonstrate how to add an image to the contact form. To achieve this, on the XAML page, within the items tag, add the DataForm custom item tag. Then, include an editor view with an image. Next, bind the profile image property to the source property of the image, which is available in the DataForm view model. Finally, to customize the position and size of the image, specify the horizontal options, height, and width. You will now observe the profile image displayed in the contact form. Next, I will show you how to add images to the data form while items are auto-generated. Before starting, remove the existing data form items. Then, set auto-generate items to true. And wire the generate data form item event. To display icons for the editor, navigate to the event handler method and check if the data form item from the event argument is not null. If it is, set the leading view to the create leading view method. In this method, I have implemented logic to display an icon for a data form based on the property type. The method creates a new label view with specified properties, assigns a corresponding icon based on the field name property of the provided data form item, and returns the created view. After that, to arrange the editor for the address group, check if the data form group item is not null. If it is, check if the data form group item name is address. If it is, set the column count to 2. Check, all the editors are generated automatically based on the property type. Look at the first editor, it looks like a text editor, but in that place, needs to display the image. To do this, create a custom data editor using the iDataForm editor interface and register this editor with a custom type for the required property using the registerEditor method. To create a custom editor, create a new class called custom data editor. In this class, inherit the iDataForm editor interface and implement its interface methods. This interface provides methods for creating an editor for the data field and handling commit and validation processes for the custom editor. Next, create two private fields, one named DataForm of type SFDataForm and another named DataForm custom item of type DataForm custom item. Then, create a public constructor that accepts a SFDataForm argument and assigns this argument to the DataForm field. In the Create Editor View method, you can create custom editors to suit your needs. Here, check the field name is the profile image. If it is, create a new instance of the image control and set the source to profile image. To customize the image position and size, specify the horizontal options, height, and width requests. After that, return an image instance. Otherwise, return null. Now, let's move to the main page CS. In the constructor, you should register the editor for the desired property using the registerEditor method. Pass the property name, for example, profileImage, as the first argument, and provide the custom editor along with the DataForm parameter as the second argument. Now, you can see the profile image displayed. Finally, I will show you how to commit values to the editor. To demonstrate this, first, I register a custom editor for the name property. Then, locate the Create Editor view in the Custom Data Editor class and assign the DataForm item to the DataForm Custom Item field. Then, check if the field name is name. If it is, create a new instance for the entry, set horizontal and vertical options, wire the text changed event of the entry, and return the entry instance. Now go to the text changed event handler method. Check if the sender is input view and the DataForm custom item is not null. If it is, call the commit value method with the argument of the DataForm custom item and entry. Then, in the commit value method, call the set value method with the entry text value. Now, observe the values manually committed to the name property when I edit in the first name editor. In this video, I have demonstrated how to add images in the DataForm, create and add a custom editor in the DataForm control. I also showed you how to commit values to the custom editor. If you want to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.